I'm going to give you an example from my own life. Now, I remember a time when I got a blessing that you would not consider a blessing. But see, everything in life is kind of relevant to your circumstances. Now, I'd just been recently divorced. And ex-wife was an unbeliever, said, if you're going to serve God, don't want nothing to do with you. I said, well, then, you know, if it's between you and God, I think I'll stick with him. Okay? That's basically the story, so. And I'm going to tell you something. I was broke. I was working a dead-end job. I had to live in an in-law apartment in my mom and dad's house. Bless their heart, they're good folks. Right? You know, child support, all that there stuff, right? Had one son, one boy, good boy. And didn't have maybe 10 bucks left over at the end of the week. 20 bucks tops, right? Things were tight after I paid all the bills. God put me there to what? Teach me to trust him and to humble me and to prepare me. And it went on for a long time. Now, when you ain't got but 20 bucks in your hand, let me tell you something, 100 bucks is a lot of money. See, when you got 100 grand in the bank, 100 bucks is what? Nothing. Right? But when you only got 10 or 20 bucks, 100 bucks is a lot of money. See, everything's relative. So I'm going to tell you, I got a blessing one day. This is God's honest truth. I'm walking down a path. An old dirt path through the woods, just taking a walk, and I looked down at the ground, and lo and behold, there's $100 bill. Now, I said, that looks like money. And at this point, I don't have much. And I looked down, and I picked it up, and oh my God, it's $100. Hallelujah, thank you, Lord. Hey, look, I ain't gonna try to find who this belongs to. This is the middle of the woods. I ain't going to put up a sign that says, you know, found $100, call this number. Right? Because then, first of all, how would you know they were telling the truth? Right? After all, right? I put it, folded up, put it in my what? Pocket. That $100 meant a lot to me. I was thinking that night, ooh, how can I spend this? Right? And again, right? When things are good, $100 is nothing. But when things are tough, that's a lot of money to me. Now I'm walking down that path. The very next day, this is weird. I'm telling you, I look down, two $50 bills. I said, is somebody trying to set me up here? This is very strange, right? But right? In the pocket. Now I got 200. I'm rich. Now I got all these plans how I'm going to spend it. Right? Then I said, Lord, why'd you let this happen in my life? Because really, 200 bucks ain't going to make my life any better. Right? Maybe 20 grand would. 200,000 would, but you know, it's nice. It's a lot of money because I got nothing. But is it really going to change my life? No. But it's a blessing. You know, I spent like 25 bucks buying some sandwiches and some stuff I wanted, you know. And right? Now I got like $1.75. And the very next day, I drive down to the market. And I say, well, let me go shopping and pick up some nice steaks. And, you know, because what am I going to do with it? I'm going to eat. No, I'm eat good, right? You know, in Italian families, the first thing you think is food, right? So I'm going to eat good. I'll mix now. I'll cook for Dad and Mom. They've been so good to me. You know, have a nice feast, right? And this is God's honest truth. God's honest truth. I'm standing in that parking lot. No sooner did I get out of my truck. No, there's no more money. No more money. No. This is the point of the story. And there's a woman in tears and a little boy holding her leg, crying. I said, is everything all right? And she started telling me a story. She said, "Sir, I'm in a bad way. You see, I was raised Muslim, and I lived in New York City. I never told anybody this story, by the way. And I became a Christian. My family kicked me out. And I came to Rhode Island, but I have a place to stay, but I have no money for food. And I was standing in this parking lot in front of the Shores, the old Shores Shopping Center down in North Providence, you know where it is, the Admiral, hoping that somebody would help me, give me some food when they come out of the store. Now, am I going to keep that $175 for me? Or am I going to give it to that woman?" Well, now here's most Christians. And I talked to her for an hour, and I could tell the sincerity in her. Now, I could say, "Well, how can you trust her? Could just be a panhandler." True. And if she did, guess what? I'd still be what? Blessed. But I was convinced it was true. Talked to her. She showed me her license. "Look, honey, here, take it, because it ain't going to change my life, but maybe it'll help feed you and your kid for a couple of weeks." Amen? See, now, but what's the point? See, some folks think they can only be a blessing to others if they got a lot. You hear what I'm saying? You can always be a blessing to somebody else. You don't need a lot to be a blessing. The widow had one mite, and she put it in, and Jesus said, "You did more than everybody else did." Get the picture? Amen. And what was God's guidance? God's guidance to me was, "John, when you get a blessing, realize I'm speaking to you. Yeah, enjoy some of it, but use it to help somebody what else?" You think God just gives us blessings to consume on our own lusts? And there's people all around us hurting in need, or the church itself has needs? Quiet again. You get the point, though, right? When God gives you a blessing, realize He's guiding you. He's speaking to you. Your next question should be, "Lord, how do you want me to use this to be a blessing to what? Someone else." You get the picture?